Lowe again. Our guest today is one of our favorite imports from Sweden. An acclaimed actress and novelist, movie audiences will fondly remember her from such films as A Double Life and House on 92nd Street. She also won favor with theater audiences in such shows as Cabaret and Glad Tidings. Please join us in giving a warm welcome to Signe Hasso. And now, here's your puckish man of the half hour, Skip E. Lowe.
Every time I hear Over the Rainbow, thinking of Judy Garland, and seeing these wonderful stars coming out of the sky, I think of those wonderful years of my childhood living in Hollywood, working with these great actresses.
Oh, yeah.
And I call movie stars. You know, I've traveled all over the world, and I must tell you, living in Paris was great. French are rude, but they're great. They have style, they're chic. And Italy, a little exciting. Living in Sweden, one of my favorite places. Germany, really, is a great country, because I love Germans. They're very, what can I say? They're definite and arrogant, but they know how to carry it. If you know how to carry arrogance, you're wonderful, and they can do it. Sweden, they tell it as it is. They're wonderful, great human beings. Signe Hasso from Sweden, Stockholm.
Stockholm.
It's cold there, but what a great place to grow up as a child and to become an actress as a child at 12.
Well, it wasn't my choice.
It wasn't?
It was just an accident. A playmate of mine from school took sick. And they said to her, do you know any other little girl? She said, oh yes, my best friend. And so I came to the Royal Dramatic Theater and met the greatest director of them all through the ages, Olof Molander. And he said, well, I think, oh yes, my mother promised me I'd get an orange if I go, because I didn't want to go. I had no idea what it was, what theater was, and I've never seen a film. So I went with this orange in my pocket, and he said, well, the director said, I think you're a little bit too big. And I took a hold of my orange, and I said, I can make myself much, much smaller. I said, oh, really? So that's how my career started, and it was a tremendous hit. I was thrown out of school because of that, and another school offered to take all the children, so on and so forth.
So at 13, you were a theater actress on stage. At 12?
Yeah. Yes.
And you started in Swedish films at 12. Did a lot of,
12,
lot of films there.
Well, yeah, I guess so.
And tell me about the Swedish film of House of Silence. This is in 1933. Was that your very first?
Well, I did. I guess so. To tell you the truth, I don't remember a thing.
You don't?
No.
It's been an exciting life for Signe Hasso.
Well, I guess so. It's been a long one.
Journey from Margaret. First American film, was it?
Yeah, but I was never in it. I was cut out.
You were?
Yeah.
Really? How come they give that in credits, these Signe Hasso?
I don't know. That was my supposed to be my first film at Metro. And they said It was a small part. And they kept adding, till it was too much. And they said, I took away from whoever else it was
who
was supposed to be the star.
Heaven Can Wait in 1943.
Yeah, that was Lubitsch.
Lubitsch.
I love him. He was a master.
Why was he such a master?
I don't know. I've been very lucky, because all through my career in this country, I've had the best of directors, like George Cukor, Ford, Lubitsch, DeMille, I can't.
The house of 92nd Street.
Hathaway.
Hathaway, yes. But tell me about the house of 92nd Street in 1945.
Well, I think it was really on 94th Street.
94th Street?
No, it was called the house on 92nd Street.
Yes.
And we had no idea when I made the film what it was all about. Not a clue.
You didn't?
No, we did it together with FBI and Hoover. And, I forgot to bring that. I have a wonderful letter from Hoover.
Yes.
Yes, who thanked me for the film.
Scandal in Paris, 1946. Scandals.
Was it?
Scandal in Paris.
With George Sanders. He was
George Sanders.
Oh, yes. You know more than I do.
Well,
I don't know a thing here.
You know which one I really loved was the Spencer Tracy. I think MGM. You were under contract with MGM, were you?
Yes, but I was on loan out most of the time.
Really?
I think I made one film at Metro, and that was
Seventh Cross. With Spencer Tracy
and Hume Cronin
and Jessica Tandy. Wonderful. I think Agnes Moorhead's in this too.
What?
Agnes Moorhead.
Yes. What does it say?
That's Agnes Moorhead. Yes. Here is the thing right here. Let's go into it. Can we see?
And Fred, do you know
look
something?
Look at this. The Seventh.
I just see something. That was Fred Zinnemann's first film.
It was.
Yeah. His very first film. He was very nervous.
How was he to work with?
Wonderful. Loved.
That was his first film?
Very first film.
Ah. Let's show a clip from this
Seventh
wonderful
Cross?
Movie with Spencer Tracy.
Yes. Oh, I love him.
The Seventh Cross. Let's see.
Courage tonight. Paul and Fiedler taking chances, endangering themselves. They don't have to do this, but they do it. Why? Phil Krabi was wrong. Why?
Spencer Tracy, one of the great actors here in this country.
Of all time.
Was he your favorite?
Yes. Spencer Tracy and the Swedish actor called Gösta Ekman, through all times, those are my favorites.
You did a great movie with Ronald Coleman.
Yes.
Called Double Life.
A Double Life, yes.
And Shelley Winters was in that.
Yes.
I think that was her very first.
I think so.
Uh-huh. Tell me about working with Ronald Coleman, great actor.
Well, you know, I heard something very funny. He was supposed to be very aloof in
aloof.
The film and never show any feelings or anything. Mm-hmm. And that's the way he did it.
Uh-huh.
And I didn't get really close to him. I mean, like, I don't have any trouble with actors at all, but I heard 2 years ago.
Right.
A relative of his came to interview me, and she said that he purposely was that way in private to get into the role.
To get into it.
Yeah, but I didn't know.
To prepare himself.
To prepare himself, yes.
Uh-huh. Tell me about Cary Grant.
Oh.
You worked with Cary.
Oh, yes,
you work with some great stars.
Yes, and some great directors.
Directors,
yes.
Too. The best.
Yeah, the best. Cary Grant, charming.
Uh-huh.
And wonderful. And Gary Cooper.
When you first arrived, Signe Hasso, when you first arrived in America going to Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer, when you went into that commissary, seeing all these great stars, which you are a star yourself, but how did they treat you? How did they look at you? How did you look at them? Were you excited? Tell me.
Well, to tell you the truth, I wasn't brought over by Metro. I was brought over by RKO.
RKO.
And I took the long trip around Russia and Siberia and Japan. I was the first actress.
I did that on a boat.
Yeah.
You did the boat thing, too?
No. Yeah, well, a train to Siberia.
A train to Siberia and take a boat across. I did the same thing to go to Japan. Yes, go ahead.
And then Japan, and
then
I had to stay in Japan for a month.
Uh-huh.
It was royally entertaining.
Why did you do that?
They wanted me. That was the only way to go, because it was 1940 and the war was on, you see.
Oh.
And that's why I had to go that long way. And they didn't mind. They got a lot of publicity out of it and things, what have you.
Uh-huh.
And then I arrived here. Never did anything for RKO. Never a thing.
You were under, they brought you over.
They brought me over. You want to hear something funny? They brought me over. And I sat there for a year, didn't do anything. Then I went off to New York.
And you did theater?
Did a play. And then I was, through the play, I was brought back to Hollywood and Metro.
What play? Do you remember? That's okay. That's okay, darling. But it was, so you did the play in New York.
We opened up the day after Pearl Harbor, I remember that.
Mm.
But what was it called? Isn't that strange? And then I was brought back by Metro. Oh, they said that if you ever are out in Hollywood, please look us up.
Uh-huh.
And my son had just been brought over from Sweden on the last ship from Sweden at the time. And we set out, and my car was someplace in Arkansas, I don't know, and I went there to pick it up, and then he and I drove to Metro, and I called them up, and did what it is. You know, they want me to do that, so that's how I got to Metro.
And you stayed in Hollywood for a long time, though, did you? Or did you go back to Sweden a lot?
No, I stayed in Hollywood till...
Because you did 60 movies. You've done 60 movies here.
I have?
You did. Yes, looking at your...
Oh, really?
Yes, yes.
Well, I don't...
You forgot.
No, but I went back to Sweden 1946 or 7, and that was... I christened the first airship. I think it was... Flagship Scandinavia, I think it was American Airlines, brought me over.
Right.
And I was there for 2 days, that's all, after all those years.
Just 2 days?
2 days.
Tell me about to the earth of the...
To the ends of the earth.
Yes, here's another one.
That was Dick Powell.
Dick Powell.
Yes.
And this was an MGM movie?
No.
No, it was...
Columbia.
Columbia.
I think.
Yes.
Columbia?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Somebody has sent all of those things to me because I have never saved them.
You have a lot of fans, you know.
Yeah.
You did with Bob Hope, too, at Paramount.
That was fun.
And William Bendix. Tell me about working with Bob
there. That was absolutely wild. It was a riot. I mean, he was as funny off the set as he was on, you know.
Uh-huh.
And that was really a takeoff on Ninotchka.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
Brother is Life, isn't that it? Brother is Life, yes.
Signe Hasso, is that your real name, Signe Hasso?
Yes.
It's real Swedish, isn't it?
I don't know about Hasso.
Hasso?
But I'm Swedish, and a lot of French in me.
In 1975, you did a movie called The Blackbird.
I did?
Yes.
Oh.
And 1977, you did a great movie called I'll Never Promise You a Rose Garden. That was a classic of all classics.
I have never seen...
You don't see your films?
No.
Really?
No.
Betty Davis says the same thing. She does it, and she forgets it, and she doesn't want to see it. You don't like... Is that what Signe does?
No, it's not that. Once you've done it, what's the use of seeing it, you know?
Why? Don't you...
No, what for? I've done it.
You've done it?
Yeah.
You don't want to see yourself on film?
Oh, that isn't it. I don't care. But
what does Signe mean when you see yourself on film? What do you think of when you see your old movies today?
Well, that was fun to see what I just now saw.
What went through your mind right now, just walking up the stairs?
I couldn't remember. I had no idea that I did it.
You don't remember that you did it? That was you?
Yeah, I know it was me. You said so.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
What has been the biggest change in Signe Hasso's life since... Because... Hollywood has changed today. You're living here.
I should say it has changed.
You grew up.
I do a lot of TV. I've done an enormous amount of TV.
You've done a lot of television.
Oh, I started, not only that, but I've done a lot of, actually TV started really in New York, you know that.
The live TV.
And that's where I lived at the time.
So you did a lot of live television.
A lot of TV, all the big Camille and Mary Stewart and all of those things on live TV.
So you did a lot of television in New York.
Oh, yes.
Before you came back.
Yes, a lot of live shows, and that was fun.
Uh-huh.
I preferred it to the film things. Somehow it gets more, I don't know.
You like the real thing, real live. And
Well, it was fun. It was hard, but it was fun.
Learning your scripts and then you're right on stage.
Yeah.
I mean, and that's taping right there live.
Well, that's right. And I did a lot of that.
Signe, looking back.
But I've lived a long time. I'm very old, as you know. Yes.
Come on. Looking back, you've had a good time, would you say?
I still have a good time.
You're writing books. You've written books now for how many years have you written books?
How many years? Well,
this one is a great film, a book.
Well, I'll tell you why it means a lot to me, because it was
this is a Swedish
anonymous
book.
It was an anonymous test. What do you call it? Competition. 604 authors.
Right.
And anonymous, so we didn't know who had won. And I won a second prize among 700 authors.
Oh, how wonderful.
Yeah. So that...
What's the book about, Signe, this one in particular? Looks like a beautiful lady sitting there, a girl.
It's not my life. It's a story of a girl.
Of a girl.
Who didn't have a mother.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Uh-huh. And she didn't know, you know. She really had a mother, but the mother didn't want to recognize her. So
uh-huh.
She called her aunt, and in the end it comes out it's uh-huh. her real mother.
The other one, you've written so many. How many have you written?
Books about... I'm on my 10th book now. Published are about eight, I guess.
Eight published books, uh-huh.
This is a book I call it in American, I call it Castle on the Moon. That's translated.
Uh-huh.
And that's a good...
You also write poetry and songs?
Oh, every day.
You do poetry, though. Beautiful. You sent me a beautiful a card, and every year you sent me this beautiful birthday card, and you write... Oh,
yeah.
It's wonderful, Signe.
Well, I write every day.
You do write every day?
And I have some... Where's my poetry book?
Keeps you alive, the poetry writing? It's not here, but that's okay.
No, it was another... But there's some of my music.
Yes, your music. Tell me about your music, Signe.
I've written a lot of music and a lot of lyrics. Liebe, 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 Fragen Hie.
Is this Swedish?
Yeah.
All Swedish?
No, that's German. German and Swedish, yeah.
Uh-huh. How many languages does Signe Hasso?
Do I speak?
Yes.
Swedish, English, and German, a little bit of French, and then through Swedish I understand I speak Norwegian.
International.
Well.
Your favorite, you have a favorite, because you've traveled like I have all over the world, do you have a favorite place in this world? A spot?
Right where I am now, in my apartment.
You're kidding.
That's it.
In Hollywood?
Yeah.
Oh, not me.
No, but I mean my apartment.
Oh,
I don't care.
Your apartment, your world. You have your own world.
I have my own world. I don't care where I am.
What is your world like, Signe? What time of the day do you get up?
I am a loner.
You're a loner?
Yes.
Greta Garbo-ish?
Well, not a loner in that sense, but I mean I love to be alone. I stay alone. Maybe this is the first time I'm out in 6 weeks.
Really?
On your show.
Really?
Yeah.
So you...
Today.
And who does your shopping? You have a lady who does your shopping?
Somebody. I had somebody who helped me with that, because I was laid up for a little while there, and I had a little...
Sweden has awarded you several times. Tell me about the awards from Sweden.
Oh, I have a lot of awards.
I know you got...
Now, let me see. I have the first film... What do you call it? The first Oscar?
Oscar. You got an Oscar from Sweden?
Oh, yeah. And then I have a few for stage.
And what is this 1989 thing?
Oh, that's the Swedish American of the Year. Yeah.
Can I get this over here, sir? Please.
That's the Swedish American of the Year.
Uh-huh.
And then I have, for the second time, got Swedish American too of the Year. And then I had the first Oscar ever, and the first for, and two, three awards for stage. And I know I have about 12 of them all together.
Really?
Yeah.
And how about this?
Oh, this is, yeah.
Tell me.
I was knighted by Sweden, by the Swedish king.
You were knighted by the Swedish? Oh, that's beautiful. Look at that.
I love that.
I think Tony Curtis got one too, something like this. Tony did, or was it from... But it was like something like this with green.
In Sweden?
No, I don't know. I thought it was maybe Spain.
That, you know something, yes, that's funny this because is this is but I was also knighted by Spain.
Spain, this is probably what Tony, here, can I see this? Look how beautiful that is. Oh, that's lovely.
Yeah. That, you know, this one, the Swedish one, I cannot wear the big one, but I have a replica, small one that I can wear. And this I have to give back when I die.
You do?
Yeah.
Why is that?
I think, David asked me the same thing. And I said, I think it's because it might be stolen, they try to sell it, you know, or something like that. And they can't. I mean, then they can, I don't know.
I see. Give me three words to describe Signe Hasso right now.
Lazy.
Oh, come on. You're home all the time.
My mind is always working, but I don't know. When I work, and when I don't work, I don't do anything.
What's the joy for Signe Hasso of acting?
Of acting?
Uh-huh, of acting.
I haven't acted for so long now.
Oh, yes, you have. Yes, you just got... Matter of fact, you just finished a film with Rob Lowe. Tell me about working...
I love
him. You see, you forget that. Tell me about working with this wonderful young man.
I love him. He was wonderful, yes. What was it called? One hell of a guy. One hell of a guy. And he was wonderful. I loved him.
He's a charming
young
man.
Yeah, he's a charming and kind.
Is he?
Yes, very kind.
Who else is in the film?
Alexandra Powers. And, this famous English actor. Oh, my God.
I don't know.
No.
But anyway, you've had a good time in the film?
Yes.
And when is it coming out?
I don't know.
You don't keep track with your movies at all?
No.
Well, the next film of Rob Lowe, you're in it, right?
I'm in it.
Okay. Yeah. What do you really want to do right now, Signe? I mean, apartment and... What does Signe Hasso really want to do?
I write a lot of poetry. I write every day. Every day.
Keeps joy and happiness.
And I have a whole... I have a whole collection called Reflectively Yours that I also did on tape so that if I ever sell it, then, you know, they can listen to it and then they can read it simultaneously. And with some wonderful drawings made by, not by me, but somebody called Stephanie Zill, whose mother is a very famous artist. She made a most wonderful drawing. I brought it, but I don't know where it is.
Mm-hmm. What do you think of young actors today, Signe? I shouldn't say that at too, but what do you think of the young actors today of Hollywood?
Oh, I feel sorry for them.
I mean, you grew up with movie stars, legends, black and white movies.
You know, I feel it's a much tougher place. It was tough enough when I got here, Hollywood. Like, but I think today it is, I feel sorry. I don't know what I feel. I hope they all make it, you know.
See, you prepared yourself to become an actress when you were a child. You went to Cabney?
Well, I started, as I said, when I was 12. And then I was went to the Royal Academy. Training seems to be... Mm-hmm.
Do you like actors, Signe? I always ask that question to actors, because some actors do not like actors.
Well, I mean... What do you mean I like? Depends on the person.
Oh, okay.
Depends on the person.
If you weren't an actress, what would Signe be doing right now?
I'd be in medicine.
In medicine?
Yeah, I would be I'd be a doctor. That was my wish.
Oh, that was your wish?
Yes, that was my wish.
How come you didn't?
Well, it was fate and my mother. I think my mother wanted to become an actress, and when the opportunity arose, when my playmate took ill, as I told you, then that's it. And then there was no other way. No, I want to become a medic, doctor.
You did?
Yes. But I'm very happy about my career, and it was my mother's dream, and I hope I've done the best with it. I hope so, because for her sake. And I just keep writing every day, and
Are you very spiritual, would you say?
I'm a believer in a destiny and in the energy.
That's
then
what
you
I
may
mean.
Call it
yes.
whatever you mean.
Yes,
whatever
that's
you
what
want.
Yes.
yes.
Whatever you can call it. Right.
Yes.
Right.
That's many names, an energy with many names.
It has, yes.
Yes.
What's your favorite film you have done? You have a favorite film that you have done?
That I have done.
That you have done.
A favorite film that I have done.
You've given me your favorite director.
George Cukor and Lubitsch.
Yeah,
and my
George.
Favorite, I think, Spencer Tracy.
Yeah.
And Cary Grant. Listen, all of them, they were fine. So was...
make Spencer
Dick Powell.
Tracy,
Dick Powell.
What makes Spencer Tracy such a great actor? He was a great listener. They say to be a good actor, listen and then react. Tell me, which is?
Well, I'll tell you something. First of all, Spencer Tracy, all of them, Gary Cooper. I was lucky. I had the best of leading men and the best of directors, so I was blessed. Now, I think the word acting is wrong.
Okay.
And actually, we shouldn't be called actors, but that's what many people do. You see, they your cup
uh-huh.
there.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
That's what people do, act. I think it's reaction.
It's reaction.
And I think we should be reactors.
Reactors, yes.
Reactors. I think reacting is that's all you have to do. Listen, and then you have to know your craft. You have to know how to speak. You have to know how to, well,
of course.
I mean, if you,
absolutely.
You have to know techniques.
Uh-huh.
And I don't know if they get that today. I don't know.
What do you think of the Institute of Actors Institute, Lee Strasberg, his method? Because you said you were an orange. You were, remember the little apple?
Well,
that's a Strasberg thing. You made
yourself small. No,
that's an object.
Well,
you became Strasberg before Strasberg. Actually,
I have no idea about
that's
the actor studio.
Anyway, that's one of the techniques they use. Look at this.
Well,
you got an award on Hollywood Boulevard, your star. Look at you there.
Here you have one of my poems, I see.
You do? What is it? Tell me. Read it or something.
Alpha, Omega, beginning and end. Which is which? They might switch, become one, be the same, except for the name.
Oh, I like that. That's great. You do write great poetry, though. I mean.
Oh, I don't know about
and the songs. Tell me about the songs you write, though. The songs.
Well, it's all
Is it love songs mostly, or?
No, you see, we have a very famous international star called Alice Babs. She could have owned America if she came here twice.
Uh-huh.
She was Duke Ellington's favorite singer.
Uh-huh.
She was absolutely a voice that you've never heard the likes of in your life.
What, she was like Edith Piafish, or what?
Oh, no. She had the highest voice you've ever heard. I mean, she was remarkable. You've never heard a voice like that.
Okay.
She made me write all her lyrics, an awful lot of lyrics. Uh-huh. I've written about 40 or something,
uh-huh.
and some of them. And she's done them all. And I won the music?
You won a lot of awards, that's all I know.
I won the Grand Prix Edison, the whole
uh-huh.
record won.
Mm-hmm.
And I won with them. And then I won for writing, and then I won. I'm lucky. Uh-huh. I have won a lot of things.
So
and then
I just like the word you just use. I am lucky.
I am lucky.
Some actresses and actors are bitter.
About
are
what?
You bitter? No, you're not bitter at
about
all, are
what?
You? Sydney, but there are actors out there today are bitter. And I'm
about
looking
what?
At you, you're so joyful and happy. And you live alone and you're happy.
Oh, I love it.
You do?
I love it. I think a lot.
Uh-huh.
I think every minute. Too much, as a matter of fact. Listen, you don't. And if you think, you're never alone. You know that.
Uh-huh.
If you
sure.
think, you're never alone.
So you like your good.
And I'm
you
old.
Like your good thoughts. You like yourself. When you like yourself, that's good.
I accept myself graciously.
Uh-huh.
But I'm old. You know.
Uh-huh.
Shall I tell them how old I am?
If you want, I don't care.
Well, I'm 83.
You're 83.
Yes. I will be 83 now.
83.
Yes.
Signe Hasso, you're sitting there telling me you are 83.
I'll be 83.
Oh, God.
Shoot.
God bless you, darling.
Isn't that wonderful?
Yes.
I'm so glad.
You're a beautiful lady, and thank you for talking to me.
Well, I love being old.
Oh, joyful. I love you. Thank you, Signe Hasso. God bless you. You're wonderful.
Are we through?
Yes.